Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So I did an aquamarine type of eyeshadow look for you today, and to me, I think summer is the best time for us to play around with colors because of the summer's festive vibe. And I think when we talk about blue or teal or aquamarine colors, we automatically think of the beach. So what is summer when we are not in the beach? But right now, I'm not in the beach. I'm at home and it's so frustrating, so I just did my makeup. Yeah. So today I used the Morphe X Kathleen Lights palette and the Wet n Wild Poster Child palette. I know they are not related, but you will see later how I did the look using both of these palettes. And I just want to share with you guys my appreciation of this palette right here. I think Kathleen Lights really did a good job creating these colors with Morphe, and this is a good value for money, I think. And I also use this for my clients, so I really love this palette. I think you all should get this one. It's really good. And yeah, if you want to see how I did this look, then please keep on watching. So guys, I've already put on my foundation. I used the L'Oreal True Match foundation in the shade W4 with my damp beauty blender. So I skipped filming that because it's just a repetitive process, so you already know how to put on foundation, I think. So let's go to the eyes now. I'm gonna use a cream shadow first. It's the Maybelline Color Tattoo in inked in pink. I'm just gonna use my ring finger for this. I'm gonna move on now to the Morphe by Kathleen Lights palette. Use the shade right here as my transition shade. Now, the highlight of the eye look today is this color right here. It's from the Wet n Wild Poster Child palette. I really like the colors, but then again, I find that these are not too pigmented. So frustrating. So to pack on this aquamarine color right here, I'm gonna use a flat brush, and I'm going to put some of the Human Heart Nature Rose Dew Mist. I don't have the MAC Fix Plus, so I'm just gonna use this one. So hopefully it will work. Okay. Tap it in here. I'm just going to put this on the lid. Next, I'm going back in with a Morphe palette, and I'm going to use this darker brown right here with a fluffy crease brush. I'm just going to blend it into my crease again. Now I want to add just a hint of mauve tone into my crease. I don't know, just felt like playing around with the color. So I'm going to use this light mauve purpley shade in the Morphe palette and also blend it into my crease. You don't really have to do all the layering of the shadows. I'm just really crazy because right now I really don't know what I'm doing. So I want to add a hint of pinkness to the look. So I'm going to use this shade from the Wet n Wild palette with the same brush. I'm also going to blend this in the crease. Just to add some warmth into it. Okay, now to finish off the makeup, I'm going to put concealer using the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the shade Sand, my favorite. With my damp beauty blender, I'm gonna blend that. You can also use your fingers. And this will also clean up all of the fallout that we had earlier. I'm glad I don't really have that much of a fallout. I was expecting a lot. Now I'm going to use my Nichido Final Powder in Cream Glow to bake my under eye. My under eyes, kasi everything just creases on my under eye. So this one really helps. If you don't like baking, you can skip this step. I'm also gonna blend it a little bit on my forehead to mattify the face. And then I'm gonna move on to eyebrows. I'm gonna use the Face Shop Designing Eyebrow Pencil. I believe it's in the shade 03. 03. Shade 03. Now I'm done with the eyebrows, I'm gonna blend away the bake. Now going back to the eyes, I'm gonna go back in with the first color that we used from the Morphe palette. Put it in my lower lash line, sorry. Next, I'm gonna use the second shade that we did a while ago. And then to have more definition, I'm gonna use the dark blue in the Wet n Wild palette. So I'm just gonna blend this a little bit into the lash line just to give some definition in there. And to kind of match it with the blue that's going on in the eyelid. Now I'm going back in with the Morphe palette. I'm gonna use this kind of red brown shade using a fluffy crease brush and kind of pushing the color slightly into the outer corner just to give a little bit of definition. Now, I want to intensify the aquamarine color a little bit, so I'm going to go back in. This time, I'm just going to use my finger, although I don't really get pigmentation, but I'm just going to try. There, I think it's already good. Now, for the brow bone highlight, I am going to use this matte cream shade from the Morphe palette. I'm just going to blend it into the brow bone. Now to finish off the rest of the face, I am going to put Revlon Photo Ready Skin Lights in the shade Pink Light, just to give some luminosity to my face. I haven't put a powder in this area yet, so yeah. I'm just going to concentrate this on my cheeks. Now for blush, I want to use the Tarte Amazonian 12-hour blush in the shade Exposed, one of my favorite brushes. So I'm just gonna put it in my cheeks. Now for highlight, I decided to just use the shimmery champagne color in this palette. So I'm gonna put it on the high points of my face. And now for the lips, I am going to use MAC Red Pearl Lipstick. It's just a pretty red browny shade. Now to finish off the eyes, I'm going to use the black shade in this palette as eyeliner. Guys, I'm so sorry. I did not know that my iPhone stopped filming, but what I did was just I put on mascara on my lashes. I used the L'Oreal Miss Manga False Lashes mascara, and then I decided to go for a lighter lipstick because I felt like it was kind of competing with the eye look. So I just stopped the MAC Retro lipstick with ColourPop's November. So it's also by Kathleen Lights. I think you all know that. So yeah, this is the rest of the look. I mean, sorry, this is the finished look. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. So if you have any more requests or any makeup tutorials that you want me to do, just comment down below or send me a message. I will really get back to you on that. And please like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye!